Hey guys, welcome to 1 Minute CM again. We have Sunita Sharma with us, and she is passionate about fitness. Not only that, she is passionate about fitness for women. She wants to preach fitness and strength. She wants to build a lot of stronger women around. So she has got a lot of qualifications which I would read out. Apart from she being an entrepreneur, she is a founder for a brand called Femme Fitness. And she is a certified strength and conditional
strength and conditioning.
Okay. She is a personalized trainer, which is certified by American Council on Exercise. She is also a master functional trainer. She is a certified fitness trainer. She is also a rehab trainer. Maybe I will need some help on that. She is also certified posture and alignment specialist. She is also a Zumba instructor, which I'm really fond of. Zumba has made an impact in India, though it's not from here. That is something I love. I've done a couple of Zumba, not practices, but attended a few events. So yeah, let's talk about Zumba a bit. And then, yeah, couple of other fitnesses. But yeah, her goal and passion is to promote fitness and awareness for women. So that's... Sunita, thanks for joining in, taking time out for this. So maybe a quick introduction about you. We want to know you better, and thanks for being the new friend.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Ravi, for having me here. You've already given a lot of my introduction already. I'll give a short story about my passion for fitness and my fitness journey, and because fitness was always a part of my life from the time I passed out of college. My first job was of a fitness trainer. So I was in Mumbai, and a very close friend of mine, she was a trainer with Talwalkers, and there was a new gym coming up, a health club coming up, and they were looking for trainers. And I was hardly maybe 19 years old. And she said, why don't you give it a try? So, I decided to join, and we were trained by great master trainers. And one of them was Lina Mogri, who was a celebrity trainer in Mumbai. And that's how my fitness journey started. And I spent good 3-4 years in that health club in Mumbai. And post that, what happened was there was this boom of call centers in between. And obviously, they were paying pretty well. And I decided to take up the job. I spent good 8 to 10 years there as well. But that didn't take, that didn't let me take my fitness a backseat. I was still inclined towards fitness. I was continuing my workouts and things like that. Then, once a woman gets married, children, putting on weight, all these things come into picture. So both my pregnancies, I had put on a huge amount of weight. So, I generally weigh around 60 kilos and I went up to 85 kilos. That's like 25 kilos extra on your body. So being a trainer, yes, I of course knew, the way how to lose weight and stay fit. But post my second pregnancy, what happens was I lost kind of motivation. I used to go to the gym, I used to work out, and I started looking for some group sessions in the community where I was living. I was in Hyderabad in Aparna Sarovar, and I was looking for some group fitness classes. Of course, not any dance classes, but I was looking for some strength and conditioning classes for myself to build some strength, but I could not find any. So that's when my husband reminded me that, I have been a trainer once upon a time. Why don't I restart it? It was a difficult call because it has been many years now, almost 20 years, to go back, revisit those memories and, all the knowledge to get that knowledge refreshed. But I still decided to dive into that, and I just announced a demo class, and luckily I got a very good response. So that's when Femme Fitness was born. So that was the beginning of Femme Fitness in Hyderabad. That was around 2014, Jan, I'm talking about. And from then, one batch to four batches a day, with word of mouth, it spread so well that I started getting inquiries from other communities as well. But physically to maintain so many batches, it was not possible for me. So that gave me an idea of expanding my brand. And getting outside trainers was not possible for me. So I thought of why not, you know, train our own people, my own clients who have been with me, and maybe, you know, give them an opportunity to be a part of FEM. And I identified a couple of them, and Shilpi was the first one who joined me, who you interviewed a couple of days back. And she was she was the first trainer with FEM. And then we had a couple of more. The team grew. There was a time where we were almost 10, 11 trainers in the team because there was a lot of demand for batches. So I took a back seat. My trainers used to conduct the sessions, and I was more into, you know, designing workout routines for different types of clients, designing nutrition plans for the client. So my time started getting invested in that more compared to taking sessions. Then there was also a time where, you know, I thought probably, you know, this is not enough. I'm not happy or I'm not contented with what the knowledge that I have. So I decided to keep upgrading myself, and hence those certifications which you just read out. So I started off with my first certification with BFI, which is Better Fitness for You. That was the starting of my second fitness career. And from then, you know, I continued with ACE. And then today I'm a strength and conditioning specialist and a nutrition coach, and thoroughly enjoying my work. FEM Fitness has been a platform for a lot of trainers, actually. When we hire trainer, or when I have trainers on my team, which are, of course, from my members itself, they are all my ex-clients who are trainers now. It provides them a platform where, you know, I literally handhold those trainers through entire training, right from, you know, the floor training, exercise training, to their soft skills training, which they learn at FEM Fitness. A few of them have started their own brand. They are not with FEM anymore, and I'm very happy for them. And few of them still continue to be with FEM. So that's my short story.
Nice. Very inspiring. So we have some compliments also coming in from Anju Patel. She's saying inspiring. So yeah, so that's a nice journey. But the important point here, which you were talking about, so you basically enabled other women to start off, because a lot of people are very, become very dicey. They do not want others to grow, but you actually gave opportunity to use FEM platform to for everybody to grow around you, including your members, clients. There will be a few people who will branch out, which is good. Because you know, people should branch out and, you know, mushroom out, and then, you know, keep doing their own thing. So, which is a good platform. So, good journey.
Let's
also get into more details about you. We want to really know you as Sunita, more than a founder of FEM Fitness. So, okay. Are you ready for some rapid fire questions?
Absolutely.
Before rapid fire, I want to share quick photographs with you. So you have to help me out the purpose of those photographs.
Okay. So,
yeah, here is the first one. Kaun hai ye?
Oh, she's a daughter of one of my clients, Sindhu. And, she stays, there's a complex next to Aparna Sarovar, Aparna Grande, where she stays. And I used to go there to conduct sessions. And she is one fitness freak, I tell you. You know, she used to join our sessions, and she used to complete the entire routine that I used to plan for my girls. And she used to inspire all of us. And I was in love with her. So every time she used to be in the session, I used to click some extra pictures of hers. She's too good. I'm not able to recollect her name, but I know her mom's name. Her name is Sindhu, and she was our ex-member.
Oh, nice.
So this was clicked when once I had conducted an outdoor session there. We had an outdoor boot camp session. That's when I took this picture.
Yeah, we lost your video. So you might have to just refresh again. We are able to hear you, Sunita. So in the meanwhile, we have another picture for you, which you have to help us out. We have compliments coming in from Shilpi, wonderful person.
You see?
Yes, there you go. So, can you see this picture?
And this picture was basically clicked in a selfie camera because there was nobody around who could help me clicking the photo. So I just placed my camera in a selfie mode, and I was doing some mobility drills the other day, and then I got a call from one of the persons from community who was organizing a run. You know, community runs they organize. So they used to organize Sarovarthon every year, and they called me and they said, you know, we would like you to conduct a good warm up session for the run. On this particular day, so we would need a write-up and a picture of yours depicting fitness and something. So that's when I had clicked this particular picture.
Cool. So we have next picture coming in. What was this quote about, and what were you up to?
Yeah, so the quote says, time and health are too precious. It's too small for me to read right now. Maybe, Ravi, you can help me read that out.
Time and health are two precious assets we don't recognize and appreciate until they have been depleted.
Correct. So, lately people with, leading sedentary lifestyle, a lot of desk work, and they don't realize our bodies have been designed to move, but we don't move enough. And by the time we realize that, it's time for us to move, it gets too late. So, let's not wait till that gets depleted and start as early as possible, because movement is eventually medicine. So that's what I wanted to convey through this picture of mine.
Cool. The next picture. What is the 21-90 rule? 21 kya hai? Matlab 90, 10, 20, 80, 35, 20, theek hai. Ye 21-90 rule kya hai?
I'll tell you, 2190, I had posted this because I had announced a challenge at that time. I think it was a challenge related to no sugar consumption for 3 months. That was the challenge all about. That, hence, that's 90. And I was promoting a lot those days that, it takes around 21 days to make or break a habit. So, people with sweet tooth, who have sweet tooth and they can't survive without having sweets, if they can control it for 21 days or 3 weeks, then it becomes, the rest of the journey is pretty easy for them. So, this was the poster that I had created at that point of time.
Good one. I agree with you because, I have a sweet tooth myself. I'm like very fond of sweets. But there are times like I've done keto twice, and I know how I can control myself. I mean, completely transform to a different diet. So yeah, I agree with this particular term. So looks like apart from men, I mean women, you also give tough time to men. So
by the way, that's my trainer. So this is Prasanna.
The punishment for coming late for training? This is part of the...
That's coming late for a photo shoot. So, earlier we used to have these trainers photo shoot off and on. And he's the only boy or man in our team, unfortunately. And we used to, when I was in Hyderabad, so my team is still in Hyderabad. I have moved to Bangalore a couple of years back. And... So that's Prasanna again. He's a triathlete, and I'm very, very proud of him. He's one push-up champion in our entire team. And every 3 to 4 months, we used to have these trainers photo shoot because, I personally like to promote all my team members on social media. Although I keep telling them that you got to do the same thing. It's like I believe in one quote, jo dikhta hai wo bikta hai. So if you don't show yourself to the world that you are a trainer and what changes you can bring into people's lives, people won't know about you. So social media plays a very, very important role. So I tried my I keep trying my bit in promoting my team members as much as possible, and I have always done that, and I will always keep doing that. So, yeah, that was one of the poses that Prasanna chose to, he decided that this is the pose I'm going to give for the photo shoot this time.
That's very nice of you. I mean, very few people do that. So I think once somebody starts their own business, or you know, once they get into a similar profession like you, they feel insecure. But I think, you know, that's not visible. I think that's also showing up in the compliments. Most down to earth person, bilkul bhi ghamand.
That's a very good Sarika. And she's one of the traders with them.
I think it's all part of the team, you know. It's you know, what you inculcate with your team. I'm sure it's not just you, but you know what they've learned from you, you know, this not being ghamand will also get carried forward. I'm sure they will also not try to put that hat and try to be ghamand and you know do it across. But yeah, we've bahut sare photos dekhe hain, but we've seen, you know, those you know, tight fits and all that. So are your kids used to, your family, your husband, you know, used to seeing you, photographing you with those, in that attire?
Yeah, they are like totally used to it now, and they pay no heed to it now anymore. If you, you know, come to my house, you'll find all my workout equipments here and there lying. And my husband sometimes, you know, tune pure ghar ko gym bana ke rakh diya hai. Can you please make some space for your equipments? So, you know, there's kettlebells around, dumbbells and power bags here and there. So my entire house is, you know, the moment you enter, you'll see a lot of equipments here and there. And you'll feel that, you know, probably, you know, she'll ask me to immediately start working out now. So yeah, they are used to it. Kids are used to it. In fact, my kids work out with me on a, you know, at least 3 to 4 days in a week. So whatever workout I design for myself, they do the same workout routine. Not that, you know, they proactively want to do it, but yeah, as a mother, I know how important physical activity is for children. So I make sure that they get some kind of physical activity every day.
Nice. So that attire is like very common. So seeing you in this picture in a very...
Where did you get these pictures from?
Okay. So this is completely different of you. मतलब ये खोद खोद के हमने ढूंढ ढूंढ के
पार डांस होमवर्क करी.
So tell something about this picture, and you know, whom are you? I mean, who is that victim you are trying to kill?
So this was last year, I think March 2019, and we had been to Satara. There's a place in Maharashtra, Satara. This is one of my best friends, and it was her son's. They have this thread ceremony, which is supposed to be a very big function. In Maharashtrians, so she's a Malayali married to a Maharashtrian and very, very close to me. So we had been, so we are like more than friends, we are like family. So whatever functions we have to attend. So I had that very day, I had finished my CSCA certification, and that was like dream come true for me. And immediately I finished my exam and we left for Satara that same very day. And this is the picture that was clicked during a function where, yeah, obviously we had to drape saris, and I love to drape sari once in a year, maybe that's like, but then hence I look different here, unlike, you know, my regular pictures with regular.
Was your husband with you? Did he recognize seeing you or seeing your picture?
Yes, he was very much with me, and he loves to see me in sari, although, you know, he's very pricey about giving compliments, but then I know he loves to see me in sari.
ये बहुत मतलब यू नो हस्बैंड फील सो जेलस राइट यू नो वाइफ अच्छे से यू नो फोटोग्राफ ले पूरा सोशल मीडिया कॉम्प्लीमेंट्स दे रहा है एंड यू नो यू डोंट रिसीव कॉम्प्लीमेंट्स फ्रॉम हिम.
दिस इज वेरी मीन एक्चुअली यू नो ही डज कॉम्प्लीमेंट बट देन इट डजंट कम आउट वेरी इजीली फ्रॉम हिम. So he's been the biggest critic in my life, and I'm very happy about it. I'm glad that he's a critic, because he's the one who keeps me grounded all the time. He's the one who always tells me, okay, this is good, this is not good, this is right for you, and he guides me a lot of time. And most of it, when it comes to my study and the knowledge that I have to gain, I think more than me, he's the one who's bothered. The moment I complete a certification, I finish one course, he's ready with the another one. He said, okay, are you done now? Is your honeymoon time over? Now it's time for you to take up another one. So yeah, he's like the backbone and the biggest motivator for where I am today.
That's really nice. Chalo, let's quickly get on to the rapid fire questions. Now we are done with the photographs.
Yeah, so, I hope I'll answer all your questions, Ravi.
What job are you really terrible at?
Oh my God.
Anybody who punishes me with the list of things they've done, which is very difficult for me to read, I definitely ask this. Kuch na kuch hoga jo wo acche se nahi karte. Technically, I know with the way your husband was responding earlier. Technically, yeah, I know your challenge, but what are the other things?
So, okay. So the job that I don't like or the job that I'm bad at?
You're bad at. You're terrible at.
Ask me the job that I don't like, please. You know, I hate cooking, but I have to do it. I just hate cooking. I somehow feel I'm not meant for cooking. But still, you know, I have to go in the kitchen, especially during lockdown. I mean, I think lockdown has made me a great cook now, because it's not that I was bad at cooking, but I don't enjoy cooking at all. So, and what am I bad at? There are a lot of things I'm bad at. Maybe, you know, yeah, one thing I'm very bad at is keeping, you know, I'll give you a very small details here. When you buy a refrigerator or when you buy a TV, they give you a long bill and they said, madam, isko sambhal ke rakhna because baad mein kaam mein aayega. And I just can't somehow remember where I have kept those things. And I keep them so meticulously that I tend to forget. So this is one thing, you know, I have never been able to figure out why this happens, but I'm sure this happens with a lot of women. So I'm really bad at, so you don't give me anything that is really very important and you tell them, Sunita, isko sambhal ke rakhna, because I'm going to forget that. So I have
Just check below the yoga mat.
Good one.
So if you're left in a, you know, forest or a wild wild forest area alone, how would you engage yourself?
Wild forest area, if there's enough food and protein, I am good. Otherwise, you know, I can keep thinking of various workout routines, you know, outdoor routines, boot camp fitnesses that we can do. About that you don't worry at all, because, you know, the moment I see any outdoors, I start getting ideas. So that would be probably some kind of motivation for me. I won't feel depressed, or I won't be feeling low at that time. So I think I can survive there.
So we have some compliments coming in. It means only cooking hater can be best trainer, so that you focus on your passion and, you know, not cook. So Mr. Sharma, please get geared up. Yeah, but the best thing, if you're left in the wild alone, you don't have to cook.
I don't have to cook.
Yeah. So in the wild, all you have to do is plant the trees and, you know, pluck the fruits and all that. You don't have to cook.
Right. I mean, hence, that's another reason why I would love to be there.
Yeah. So what would you miss there? What is that one thing, if you're left alone, what are the things? Like,
if by I'm alone, I would my kids, first, obviously. Both my children.
Okay.
So that's one thing I miss.
I know. So an event in your life that can make a good movie.
There is an event which can make a good movie. There are a couple of them, rather. I'll just tell you one of them. We had been to Vaishno Devi, and there was some landslide, and I'd been with my husband, my brother, my mom, dad, everyone was there, and we got stuck in a landslide, and, you know, the whole scenario was such that as if I was reading some thrilling novel at that particular time. When I recollect those memories, and, you know, even today when me and my brother, we sit back and we talk about that particular incident, it feels as if you're going through some thrilling novel, you're reading a novel, or you're watching a movie. So you can actually make a movie on that particular incident. It was really, really bad. So that's one bad incident which I can talk about, which I don't want it to occur. But yeah, you can make a nice movie on that for sure. Yeah.
Okay. What do you miss the most in your childhood?
Miss the most in my childhood. My childhood was pretty much okay. Schooling, I loved the school part. Nothing in particular as such, but nothing in particular, Ravi. I mean, it was a good childhood memories that I have. nothing to grumble about. I anyways loved to study even at that time. So, you know, I can't crib that. You know, my mom used to, you know, pester me to study. And so, yeah, it was good. I was in sports. I was in academics. And quite balanced kind of a girl in school. But, yeah, my brother's friends, you know, they used to probably, you know, every now and then, since they knew I had some girlfriends and some of them were pretty good looking. So they used to be friends with me only because they wanted to, you know those girls. So this used to really irritate me and annoy me a lot of times. But that's fine. I mean, these are some nice memories that, you know, one should have.
Yeah, this might be happening now also, right? You know, some of your clients might be joining this particular program of yours because, you know, your team is completely filled with pretty...
Thank you for the by the way. I'm sure all of
that has not left you. That is not something which you're missing. That's still happening.
Yeah, we do come across some clients, you know, who tend to get a little personal. But then, we also know how to draw a line between being professional and personal. So, all good there. So far, so good.
Any favorite candy of yours which is not available now? Childhood, kuch to hoga.
Favorite candy.
Candy, yeah. Some chocolate okay. Or candy
is not available. I'm not sure whether you are aware of it because I don't know how old are you, Ravi, because I am 44 and we used to have this.
41. I'm just 3 years younger to you.
Okay. So we used to have this Pepsi Cola that we used to get. I don't know if you remember. You remember those different flavors in cola, orange and all these things? I really miss those because I used to love those, you know, used to get them small size and big size and amazing taste. After we used to finish our school, we used to buy those. And we also used to get these golas outside the school where, you know, they used to make fresh golas and put some nice syrup on it and have it. So those are the things I miss these days.
Good. What's your favorite music type, music genre?
You know, I prefer some, I'm not a very typical music lover types, but I like music and it could be anything, could be anything that it's good to hear, you know, it sounds good to my ears. So, of course, a lot of Hindi songs and a lot of Hindi songs, maybe I can tell you from 90s. Where, you know, a lot of Kumar Sanu songs, so that's something I love to listen anytime.
That's
Kumar Sanu, Udit Narayan, all these singers.
Okay. Name one of your songs which you heard on MTV those days.
Can you come again?
Name one song, music video, which you used to hear in MTV. Channel MTV, remember?
Okay. Mm-hmm. You remember Shahid Kapoor's first video?
Yes.
Aankhon mein tera hi chehra. That's the one. I love that one. And I still listen to that sometimes. I still watch that video.
Yeah. The audio and video is still really good. Song. I mean, you can play it and watch
it. It's good. Nostalgic.
Good one.
You just brought back those memories.
So, which game you find the most funniest?
Which game? Are you like, you want me to talk very seriously about a game here? Or, you know.
Yeah, any game you feel very silly. Like I don't like cricket. I feel like, ek ball ke peeche, yahan pe 11 log, wahan pe 11 log. Why are you guys fighting? It's supposed to shop mein mil jayega ek ball ke peeche. Like that, you know, do you find any game...
I don't think I find games. Any games that probably make you move, I will not find them silly at all. But maybe if you asked me, you know, a few of some board games where you just sit down and just move around those coins and probably, you know, could be boring. But not really. I think, you know, I'm not the right person for you to ask me which game you find silly. Because, yeah, any physical games, you require those. Otherwise also, you know, even if you play chess or any mental game, you require those as well. So, yeah, but then everybody's choice is different. I completely understand, Ravi, why you don't like cricket.
Yeah. What is the weirdest thing one of your friends have done after they got drunk?
weirdest thing one of my friends have done after the
they got drunk, matlab completely tully ho gaye to.
Okay, so you want me to talk about my friends doing this?
Yeah, don't name them, but you can just say one of a friend ye party mein ye hua tha.
Oh, again, there are many memories. There was one of my friends, she's not in India anymore, she's moved abroad, and we're not really in touch anymore, but she got really drunk, and she went to the DJ counter, and eventually, you know, she annoyed him so much. She wanted him to play one particular track, and he was like, I already have a list of tracks to be played and this and that. And she was completely high, and she ended up arguing, and eventually it went into a hand fight. It was like a fight, you know, literally a fight between him and the DJ, that we had to drag her back home. So yeah, it was kind of embarrassing as well, but yeah, that was because she was drunk.
Yeah, good one, good memory. So we have some questions also coming up from the audience. Anju Patel, how do you encourage women to focus on their health?
A very, very important topic, and I can keep on talking on this particular topic. So especially in Indian society, we women, we tend to neglect our health, and you know, our health takes a backseat because we have so many other responsibilities to take care of: our children, husband, in-laws, house, this, that, plus our work. So you know, fitness is like, acha time hoga to karenge type. So but I have been promoting, and I will always be promoting this, that you know, if a woman is not fit enough, she cannot take care of the household. So 1 hour in a day, so even if it's not 1 hour, at least 30 minutes you have to dedicate for yourself. And this doesn't just go for women, it goes for everyone, men and women both, because these days the kind of lifestyle that we lead, the kind of food that we're eating, we survive on fast food most of the times, which is, you know, quickly available, can be cooked easily, and it's you know, filled with the hyper palatable you know, ingredients in that we just can't stop eating. End up what we tend to put on weight, plus you know, it puts extra load on our heart, we are not moving enough. So all this club together gives you an unhealthy lifestyle. Now if a woman of the house is not healthy, I don't think she can keep the entire family healthy. So I would suggest, I know it's difficult and I know it's challenging, but you have to put your foot down and you have to decide that, you know, this 30 minutes belongs to me and I have to give it to my body because my body deserves it. In a lot of family, and these are instances which I'm sharing, which my own member shared with me. They said, if I work out, my in-laws feel that I'm trying to show off. So one of my members had shared this, I will not name the member. So I think there's you know, lack of awareness in our society, especially people are quite conservative when it comes to women working out, and it is still the scenario. We feel that, you know, we have evolved. Yes, we have evolved to a certain extent, but we need to change this mentality of people, and it's like aurat ki dushman types, you know. So very important that we change this mentality and create more and more awareness. And at Fem Fitness, this is the first thing that we try to do, that, you know, one should be aware why you need to indulge into a structured exercise regime if you know that your lifestyle is sedentary, otherwise your work is, you know, is a desk job, unless you're in a field job. Yeah, that's another thing, because your heart is getting enough of activity that it needs. So yeah, it's very, very important. So how do I encourage women to focus on their fitness? This is how I encourage, because you know, this is how we create awareness. We need to show them the mirror ki boss ye zaruri hai aapke liye.
Cool, good one. So we have further questions. So we have a question from Syed Faraz, but before that, I, you know, thoda fitness se hatke, let's go back to your two school days memories that you relish the most.
Relish the most, huh? Okay. One of the memories was when I was in school, I was good in art. in drawing and painting. So there was an inter-school competition, and I was very small. I must have been in grade 2 or 3. I was very small. And so there was a competition, and one of my drawings was, and I had drawn a nice shaded elephant in that drawing. And I didn't know, without my notice, my drawing teacher, he sent that drawing for a competition entry. And one fine day, I got to know that, my drawing was selected, and I bagged the first prize in that. And, you know, being small, you get excited about these small things. Plus, you get to know that, you know, there's so many other schools and you're the one who's been selected. So I think that memory is still with me. And you will not believe the prize money at that time. I had got some 101 rupees in an envelope, and for many years I had kept that envelope. I didn't even, you know, spend that money and kept it with me. But yeah, for me it was very precious. So that memory, I think, will always be with me. So that was one memory.
Second memory.
Oh my God. Second childhood memory. With the problem of, you know, remembering things, you're asking me to remember my memories. It's a big task for me, Ravi, right now. another memory I could say, this was not really childhood, but this was when I was in college. Can I narrate this one to you? This is again related to my brother. So my brother was, we were in Mumbai, and he was in SIS college and I was in Ruya college. So SIS is in Sion and Ruya is in Matunga. And knowing him, you know, he always used to skip his classes. And my father was a businessman at that time. We had a factory and office in Mumbai. And he came to me and he said, you know what, principal has called the guardian. I said, okay. He said, please come along. I said, no ways, I'm not coming. Okay. He said, no, someone has to come. If I tell dad, he's going to bash me up. So I decided to go. And, I thought, okay, I'm going as a guardian and things. I was quite excited. And the kind of bombarding I got it from the principal, I was like, I told my brother, don't you dare ask me to come with you again. So that's one memory again I can never forget. But I cherish these memories. I really cherish them.
What did you do? Matlab, thoda jyada makeup. Matlab, while going there, I'm sure you got prepared. You want to look elderly and all that. So talk about that.
I just told, you know what I told the principal? I told the principal, you know what, my brother, he's trying to learn the business that my father, runs. So he has to go to office and he spends a lot of time there. So principal, unko bolo, wahi pe baithe rahe. College aane ki zarurat nahi. It was really embarrassing. I hope my brother is watching this session right now.
Good one. So we'll come back to the question. Mr. Sayed Faraz Zaidi is asking, can you talk about some stress buster activities at home?
Stress buster activities, I think it depends from person to person. For some people, listening to good music is like a stress buster for them. For me, exercising is like a stress buster. The day I don't exercise, I go cranky. I literally lose it, and my husband says, "Ek kaam kar tu thoda the gym jaake aaja, you'll feel nice." So yeah, for me, working out is like a stress buster. You can indulge in some activities that you like, your hobbies. You know, once you leave or disconnect from the rest of the world and just focus on what you like to do, I think it can help a lot in stress busting. So yeah, you need to find your own activity, what really makes you happy.
Yeah, Farazab, what I do when I'm really stressed, I start making new friends.
Oh, great. I think that's a very good habit. In fact, you know what? Lot of people, when they are under stress, they tend to binge eat. They tend to eat. They feel that, you know, probably that is their comfort. That makes them feel comfortable. But you need to look out for some kind of activity where, you know, it doesn't harm you. By eating, obviously, you will just put on weight. And if you're not moving enough, again, it adds up to that. So, yeah, look for some kind of activity that makes you feel good.
Yeah. I was just kidding, but my stress buster is basically music. So I get onto this particular room, you know, put on loud music, close my eyes, and I tend to listen to music. So.
And go in trance totally.
Yeah. Good one. So we have a few more questions coming in and comments.
Wow, a lot of people asking questions.
Yeah,
huh?
Sabina talking about her journey, fitness journey just started in lockdown, and, you know, she is complimenting you. The credit goes to this lady.
Actually, you know what? I'll tell her story. I would like to share her story. She has been my friend for almost 18 years now. And yeah, we used to work together. And she was not overweight earlier, but then she put on weight and, you know, she moved to London for a few years and she came back to India. And, you know, I have this, I keep pestering my friends, ki chalo saath mein workout karenge, chalo saath mein workout karenge. But then it never used to happen. She never used to get motivated and she's like, arre yaar, please. And she was always full of excuses. I'm sorry, Sabu, if I, you know. So,
she's already saying, oh my God.
So, but then, when the lockdown happened, no, I completely agree. She's a busy mom. Both her children, they play badminton on professional level. So, you know, she has to take care of their coachings, trainings and things like that. But when the lockdown happened, I think it did good to a lot of people because, you know, we were home and we didn't have those extra responsibilities which we had. And then I thought, let me give it a try again. So I said, okay, why don't we work out together? Now, she didn't have any excuse to give me, right? Ki, I'm busy, I'm not at home. So, karna hi pada. And thus we started and we've been working out together for past 2 months now. And we work out every alternate day. We conduct sessions on Hangout or Zoom. And we do our expo sessions and she's lost quite a lot of weight now. So I think that's the reason she mentioned that.
So Sabina, you know, I will not cut this particular part of the video. I will not post it and on Facebook and tag you. I will not do that. I promise you that. So relax. Yeah. But you have a cute daughter based on the DP. I'm sure, you know, Sunita will convert you back to the way your daughter looks now. So all the best on that. So yeah, I think we have Kaiti Mehta for specially able to do design courses. If yes, I would like to communicate. I am inspired to be a fastest walking marathon as with my prosthesis walking.
Prosthesis walking is I can do and I have. Okay. So I think Kyati's is a medical scenario here where, you know, I think she's aspiring to be a marathon, a walking marathoner. And yes, I don't think anything is difficult in this world. In fact, one very important thing that you need to take care of, Kyati, is strengthening of the muscles, which is very, very important. Whatever sport you are, you know, whatever sport you want to pursue, you got to strengthen the muscles that are involved in that particular sport. So what I would recommend is you should approach an expert or a professional strength and conditioning specialist and let them design a program for you, or you can train under them. I'm sure you know it will help you reach your goals soon.
Sure, and Kathy, feel free to you know, reach out to Sunita, and you know you can have this conversation. And I'm sure the short duration, you know, instead of that, maybe you know, get in touch with her, and you know.
Yeah, most definitely.
Okay, so we have the next question coming in. Two friends you have slapped.
I have never slapped anyone in my life. Friends, I have never slapped. I have slapped a man. You know, in Mumbai, we used to travel in local trains. And he tried acting smart with me and I slapped him. I had to slap him. But otherwise, never. None of my friends, I never slapped them. Arey, manna hai kya unko slap karke?
So, slap karne ke baad bola, fan fitness karke?
No, I was in college that time, so... I was going to college and he tried acting smart. But yeah, parents have made us so strong enough to at least face these situations.
You know, I think you answered my next question. My next question was one memorable city bus.
City bus, yeah.
You traveled in a bus because you were speaking about metro and, you know, Mumbai. So, I'm not sure if this is a question, but have you experienced riding in a city bus, and do you have any memories?
I have experienced many years traveling in the local train, which is, I think, the bark of all the travels and all the city buses in any of the city. If you can travel in Mumbai local train, you can survive anywhere in the world. And that too during peak hours, proper peak office hours, oh man, it's a challenge. So it's been like many years I haven't done that. Maybe, you know, next time I go to visit my friend in Mumbai, I should try doing that.
Okay, for this next question, you have to be very honest, okay, Sunita? So
I was honest in all your questions. I answered all your questions honestly.
Abhi bhi proposals aate hain?
Oh, okay. I am very honest and abhi bhi aate hain.
That's like
a short and sweet response. Yeah, I mean, see, you know what, when you're on social media, especially when you're connected to fitness line, obviously you'll keep getting a lot of, your inbox is forever full with lots of messages, which, you know, we don't even tend to read sometimes. And you just have to neglect them. You can't do much about it. Maybe, you know, I mean, they can't be genuine, of course. Once you know a profile of a person is married with two children. My daughter is like 13 years old. I mean, you can't be serious by, you know, so you just need to neglect such things.
But aap log bahut smart se lagate ho apna profile picture. I mean, I told this to other person also, Reena also, who gave the interview last time. Aap log ka na bahut ye rehta hai, matlab profile picture mein apne photos rehte hain, pure kahin pe niche family ka photo rehta hai, ek do photo. So bahut
it's maybe, I think it's got to do with the profession that you are in. So if you check my profile in earlier years, maybe before 2012, you'll see a lot of family pictures there. But from the time I started Femme Fitness and from the time I took up fitness as a career, it's obviously it's going to be my pictures and, you know, my job, my workout, my fitness routine. So
most expensive piece of clothing you bought?
Most expensive piece of clothing. So it can be anything, right? It can be a sari or anything, because saris are quite expensive, especially the Kanchivaram saris. I think most expensive piece of clothing is a sari which I bought, which was, I think, for some 13,000-14,000 rupees. For me, that was expensive because I don't wear saris enough. Probably, you know, I would prefer investing in my gym clothes rather than investing in a sari. So, you know, investing on one particular apparel, that to 14,000 rupees, probably I could buy a lot of gym apparels in that.
Okay. When you're talking about strength and all that, what are the heaviest things you lifted?
What are the heaviest things
you lifted?
Heaviest things, as you mean heaviest weight I have lifted?
Yeah, weights and...
Yeah, so I am into weightlifting and I deadlift around 85-90 kilos when I'm at my best, at my best fitness levels. So I can deadlift around 80-90 kilos. Otherwise, I generally deadlift with around 70 kilos on a regular basis. But post-lockdown, yeah, you know, whatever available in the house, usi mein karna padta hai, jo bhi manage, jo bhi weight ghar pe hai. I'm not talking about the people in the house, of course. I'm just talking about whatever weight available in the house.
Yeah, somehow your team members are like, you know, ask us, you know, even Nike and shoes are very expensive. Workout gears are very expensive.
So, yeah. My workout gear, I like to invest in my workout gears. I like to invest in my shoes. I have close to 18 pairs of shoes right now with me currently. But being a Virgo, I think it's a Virgo trait. You know, when you like something, one thing, you keep wearing that same thing. So if you see my latest videos, I had purchased a set of a pair of Nike Epic React just a few months back. And I'm wearing literally those shoes in each and every video. And my husband is like, baki jo hai na unko daan kar do pehle. Or tumko to wear anyways, you have to wear just one pair. So just donate the rest of the shoes. So yes, I do invest a lot in my shoes, my workout gear, and a lot of in my equipments as well. I don't compromise on these things.
Yeah, so Mini, Anju, Sarika, so investing in shoes, workout gear is investment. Expense is saris. Okay, so anything which you're investing on your workout is investment. So don't take it as cost.
Yes, that's my investment.
Yeah, good one. Your secret admirer?
My secret admirer? I don't know. I mean, hoga koi pata nahi. I mean, hai bhi ek do shayad, you know, maybe they have not expressed it openly to me, but toh sabhi ki life mein hote hain waise toh. So I really don't know who's my secret admirer. I probably just assume hoga koi to.
Yeah. So Sabina is saying, I think you must have rapid fire questions with her friends. Sabina, I will do that, but just after the rapid fire questions with Sabina, I really want to see you. You really want to see Sabina, who's transformed, who's had a lot of difference after the lockdown. And I want to see your daughter along with you, Sabina. So this is.
Oh my God, they just don't stop talking. So Ravi, you know, I'm warning you. If you want to interview them, they just don't stop talking. They're non-stop.
Okay, so the last question. Who's that one person, you know, guy or a girl, who will like all your pictures and they should not be part of your team? Tumhare team members nahi hai, but they will definitely for a long time has been liking your pictures, anything you post. That one
first,
person.
First is Sabina. She's not in my team, but she likes each and every post of mine, each and every picture of mine. Whatever I post, she has to like it. So she's one person who likes each and every post of mine. And there's one more person on Facebook. I don't know him personally, but he's a runner. He's a marathon runner. And I just happen to know him from a running group. His name is Mr. Sanjay Dalmia. And he's one person who likes all my posts and pictures.
See, you're inspiring so many people. So you said you only want to concentrate on women. And yahan pe Faraz saab getting motivated. There are other people also who is liking each and every picture of yours. So
yeah, you
should not just limit yourself with women, but yeah.
We train men as well. It's not that we don't train men, but we Femme Fitness all started with the idea of training women and bringing fitness to their doorstep. So that was a whole idea for them. But then, yeah, we started getting inquiries from men as well. So we do train men also. All our female trainers train men, and even Prasanna for that matter, we have in our group. So yeah, we do train men. It's not that it's only women. In fact, we train kids as well. We have kids fitness also.
Good. So Sabina is like, yes, my daughter is a big fan of Sudita auntie. Ye, last wala bit thoda.
So yeah, her daughter is 7 years old and she's a badminton player, and if you see her fitness levels, I mean, she can inspire anybody in this world. She does pull-ups, she does push-ups, and the way she does the high intensity workout or any kind of workout, I mean, you will just keep looking at her. She's such an amazing kid. And yeah, she is a fan of mine, because you know, whatever she learns in terms of fitness, she wants me to see it first. So she's like, Mama, please call Sunita aunty, I want to show it to her. When she learned to do handstand, she, you know, her mom had to video call me and show it to me. So she's like, okay, dekh le yaar, ye tujhe dikhana chahti hai bahut time se. So yeah, she is a fan of it. She's, I think, the youngest fan of mine.
Yeah, so she should be on the show. By the way, Sunita and, you know, rest of the friends, we also have some young, passionate kids who are coming on the show. You know, we've done that. Siddharth Billy, the youngest scientist, data scientist. We also have a little angel coming in shortly. We're mesmerizing with her, you know, daily videos. She's coming up shortly. So, yeah, Sabina's daughter can also be one of them.
So, her name is Siana, and I'm sure Siana should be in this, you know, show soon. She's going to inspire a lot of people for sure.
So who's Sanjay Dalmia?
So this is one of my Facebook followers who likes each and every post of mine. Actually, there are a few more, but yeah, these are two people who I remember, who I know, okay, they are going to like my post. Yes.
Nice. So that finishes the rapid fire questions and, you know, questions from the audience. Thanks for taking time for these particular questions. Now the main point. If you become the chief minister, so what are the areas you would focus on?
Wow, pehle to chief minister ki bana de, it's a big thing, you know. Then you need to sit back and relax yourself and then start thinking ki ab main kya karungi. So I think I have a couple of things that I would like to introduce if I become a chief minister of a state. Firstly, this is through personal experience that I'm talking about. As I mentioned earlier, these days, you know, children, they don't indulge into a lot of physical activity. They have gadgets at their disposal. They just spend a lot of time on tabs and TV, watching TV, and they don't move enough. So there's, you know, obesity on the rise, kids obesity, child obesity on the rise. And there are around close to 22 million people, children under the age of 5 were obese in the whole world. And that's like, you know, that's alarming for us. So why I'm saying all this is because in a lot of big communities where, you know, these communities have these landscaping and there are a lot of gardens and parks in the community itself, where they don't let the children play. Reason being, aesthetics kharab ho jayega, ya fir park kharab ho jayega, garden kharab ho jayega, grass kharab ho jayega. Yeah, correct. So what happens is children don't get enough place, enough space to play. Where will they play, right? So if I become the chief minister, I would make it mandatory in each and every community to have a big ground for children to play, and aesthetics will be secondary, landscaping will be secondary. So that's the first thing I would introduce, because I know how important it is for children to move and move their bodies. Each and every child should have a structured 60 minutes of physical activity every day, which we do not have these days. And if we have open space or play areas for children, I think that will take care of it. So that's one thing that I would like to introduce. Second thing, can I talk about second thing as well, or I just have to speak once?
No,
okay.
You please.
Second thing, which is again to do with the children, I have been reading a lot about youth fitness, and I train a lot of athletes as well who are badminton players, cricket players. So, you know, in schools, we have this physical education period. Some schools have 3 days a week, some schools have 4 days a week. And so we tend to make them play some sport, or we make them do some kind of yoga or some kind of activity. But if I become a chief minister, probably I would introduce again a structured exercise regime for these children, where they understand the importance of basic movements which make us more functional. So movements like squatting and hinging, picking up things from the floor, deadlifting, pushing, pulling, these are the movements which our entire life revolves around. These are the movements which we perform on a day-to-day basis thousands of times in a day, right? So there should be something introduced where we make them so strong in these basic movements, because each and every exercise is connected to these movements itself. So once your fundamentals are strong, I think, you know, in the later life, there will be less of physical problems, or there'll be less of lifestyle disorders or lifestyle related diseases that we'll be encountering. So these are two things that I would like to introduce as a chief minister. I'm not too sure whether a lot of people will agree with me on this, but since I'll be the chief minister, toh main karwai lungi.
That's awesome confidence. So yeah, valid point. I mean, the second point, you know, kids, not only about the strength and all that, now it's an era where immunity is really important, and you know, it has to build from childhood. So that's a very valid point. And the first point I want to reiterate, yes, it is a you know, good point which you mentioned. The gardens or the common areas which are there are, again, as per government rule, they're part of GHMC. So the 40% which we leave it as a garden or for the lawn are showcased as a GHMC property or the municipal property by the government law, and right. That is for playing. So any community which is restricting kids not to play there, they're basically violating the rule. Government there, aap greenery badao, use it as common area for playing, and that there is a reason for designing that. So that people are just not making concrete jungle out of the entire 100% of land which they are developing. So, yeah, 40% mein, there shouldn't be a community which is restricting. So, you know,
out of my experience, you know, I've lived in Bombay, I've lived in Jaipur, Hyderabad, Bangalore, Pune. In most of the communities, you know, I always used to, whenever kids want to play in some area, they used to be like, "Arey yaar, ghas kharab ho jayegi, koi aur jagah dhoondo khelne ke liye." Now, in today's scenario, I will not want to send my kid outside the road or outside the gate to play, because, you know, it's not safe. I don't find it safe enough. So I might as well make him play inside the community. So I think maybe, you know, people can agree or be a little flexible on their rules and, you know, their planning somewhere so that, you know, it can work in favor of the children.
Yeah, the second point in that particular, you know, grass thing, in US there is already a movement which is going on. People are giving up on grass because, you know, it takes, consumes a lot of water. And, you know, water conservative, conversion, जो भी वाटर कंजर्व करने के लिए फाइट करते हैं, दे बेसिकली आर फाइटिंग अगेंस्ट ग्रोइंग जस्ट लॉन्स इन फ्रंट ऑफ द हाउस और बिहाइंड द हाउस, बिकॉज़ इट कंज्यूम लॉट ऑफ वाटर वर्सेस व्हाट इज द यील्ड दैट इज गिवन, लाइक कितना पानी आप पेड़ को दे दो, इट विल एटलीस्ट गिव यू सम ऑक्सीजन एंड ऑल दैट. सो पीपल आर मूविंग आउट ऑफ ग्रासेस, सो यू नो दिस इज अनदर पॉइंट व्हिच यू नो एड्स अप टू इट. बट या वी हैव कवर्ड ऑलमोस्ट यू नो 1 आवर ऑफ दिस. So thanks Sunita for you know taking time out for this. You know, keep up your passion, keep inspiring more women. You know, I'm sure there are a lot of new people who would friends who would start following you, because seeing your pictures, seeing what you're doing, your team is doing, you know, whether they are able to come physically to your workshop or not, take up a workshop from your team or not, but seeing the pictures, it motivates many to, you know, do some or the other work, you know, activities at home, at least do try some things on their own. So keep up spreading this passion around and inspiring women to become more stronger, so that, you know, they can handle themselves. And all the best with your entrepreneurial journey, and spread this positivity through your Femme Fitness. And thanks for taking time out for answering all the questions from the for the audience. So
thank you, Ravi. I think I enjoyed this session a lot. I enjoyed all the questions you shot today. And yeah, I mean, my mantra of fitness will always be and always remain the same. I will never stop mentoring the new trainers. I'll not stop helping anyone who needs any kind of help when it comes to fitness. My doors are all open, and इतना सारा नॉलेज जो जमा किया है, आई मीन अनलेस यू यूज दैट नॉलेज और यू शेयर दैट नॉलेज, आई डोंट थिंक यू नो यू आर रियली मेकिंग यूज ऑफ दैट नॉलेज. सो आई विल कीप डूइंग इट. थैंक यू वेरी मच. इट वाज यू नो माय प्लेजर टू बी हियर, एंड इट वाज अ ग्रेट सेशन. आई लव्ड एवरी बिट ऑफ इट. थैंक यू वेरी मच.
थैंक यू सुनीता. सो आई हैव अ न्यू फ्रेंड, सो थैंक यू.
हैप्पी फ्रेंडशिप डे.
हैप्पी फ्रेंडशिप डे.
थैंक यू.
Thank you. Great.